Well, today, a visiting Bill Gates put pressure on the Australian government to commit more to foreign aid. As a philanthropist, he and his wife Melinda have given more than $28 million to charity. Here, philanthropy, well, it's not quite taken off like it has in Europe and the United States. Donations from individuals total around $1.8 billion a year. Yet philanthropic trusts are vital for sectors that rely on donations. Tonight, our focus interview is with philanthropist, businessman and former Wallaby captain Phil Kearns, who says Australians can and should do more. Phil, thanks for joining us. Look, your path has changed dramatically since you left the Wallabies. How has it changed you personally, dedicating as much of your life to charity as you do now?
13 years ago, I got involved with the Humpty Dumpty Foundation. I started a run called the Balmoral Burn, which was initially just to put a lick of paint on the walls at Royal North Shore Children's Ward. But things sort of got out of hand from there, and 13 years later, we're having our 13th Balmoral Burn, and we've raised over $15
million. $15 million. I bet you never allowed yourself to imagine that you might raise that much.
No, my first intention was to have one Balmoral Burn and to raise 10 grand. And literally, I was thinking I'd buy the paint myself from Bunnings or wherever, and then go down with the paintbrush and paint the walls. And that was sort of as far as my vision was heading at that point.
And so now, of course, you can afford much more than a single paintbrush.
Well, now, we can buy more than a paintbrush and some paint, and we now support 208 hospitals around the country, most of them in New South Wales, but certainly in every state we support, and also in East Timor. And we buy life-saving equipment for those hospitals, and it's pretty satisfying.
It must be, to say the least. What sort of equipment and what sort of practical difference, I guess, can that make to these children's lives?
You know, the equipment is everything from ambulances, and in the case of East Timor, a four-wheel drive ambulance. Kids were dying literally because cars were getting bogged, and so we bought a four-wheel drive ambulance, humidity cribs. We've helped fund the Gates Centre at Westmead to help kids with cerebral palsy how to walk and to help them walk. And right through to probably the most simple piece of equipment is what's called an Easy IO, which is a drill virtually that drills into a child's shin bone. When kids get very ill, their veins shut down and they can't be given drugs through the vein, so they have to go through the shin bone. This piece of equipment costs $1,700. You know, for $1,700, would you give that to save a kid's life any day of the week?
You mentioned before that this has been pretty rewarding, to say the least, but do you ever get the opportunity to meet with these children yourself and their families? And there must be some pretty special moments there.
Yeah, we do, and those families come to the Balmoral Burn dinner each year, and they're there to support us, they're there to thank us.
And what do they say to you?
To give back a child's life or their child's life's important. I mean, don't forget, you know, I had an accident with my girl, with my daughter, and when I ran her over, and the equipment that helped save her life was donated by Humpty. She was only about 18 months old when the accident happened. So I'm a strong believer in karma, and you know, I'm one of those people that have directly experienced the benefits of what we do.
Australia as a nation, well, we're very wealthy, but do we do enough in terms of philanthropy?
I think Australians have a great propensity to give, and we give when the time is right to give. You know, normally disasters and things like that is when we put our hands in our pockets. Not everything is a disaster, however, and things need ongoing funding. If you compare us to where we would be in the world versus Americans, for example, we're a long way behind. We give about 1/10 of the amount of what American households give to charity. So we've got a long way to catch up there. Australians generally, yeah, we're generous, particularly with our time and with helping people. But in terms of our money, we haven't quite caught on yet to other, let's call it, best practice standards around the world.
Excellent. Phil Kearns, thanks for joining us.
It's a pleasure.
And Phil's charity event for the Humpty Dumpty Foundation runs this Sunday.